Okay, the introduction of the latest 24-inch iMac was followed by some of the most polarizing comments by the tech community. Nevertheless, it did not make an impact, at least a lot of it, on wider population. Most of the time, it never does. Yet, how does it compare with another desktop-class Mac with the same chip in its heart? Let me share with you why I think to compare these two is a little bit more complex than some may have thought. Hi friends, and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco and this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, rumors and opinions. Don't forget that this video, as well as any other till Wednesday, will let my subscribers to enter a raffle and get an opportunity to win another Digital Marketing's giveaway. MOFT Snap tablets then will be given to one of you this Friday. So you want to enter and win? Subscribe, leave a comment and hit the like button. Oh, and yeah, enable notifications so you don't miss the next video. I have to admit, there will be those who may not be very happy with what I'm going to say, but at least understand we all have different priorities and we value things differently. So please feel free to share your opinion. There is no doubt that both Mac and iMac are two very impressive desktop machines, and while they are not designed as pro devices, with the M1 now on board, it is easy to give them a chance. Obviously, Mac Mini, at least the one that is powered by Apple Silicon, comes in two variations, while this year's iMac is coming in three configurations. To make things simple, I will compare basic options. While if differences between editions are bigger, I will do my best to mention it. These computers are really similar in terms of performance. Maybe when M1X Mac Mini comes out, it will add more punch. Yet, at the same time, we may see new iMac Pro, possibly 32-inch counterpart. As far as connectivity goes, it's quite interesting battle. With two Thunderbolt USB 4 ports, two USB-A, HDMI 2, Gigabit Ethernet, out of the box, an audio jack, Mac Mini brings more to the table, especially if you compare it to base model iMac. While you can reconfigure it, for $30 more, you'll get Gigabit Ethernet and, of course, all along, two Thunderbolt USB 4 ports and 3.5-inch headphone jack, but it will still miss those two USB-A ports. For some, there is advantage if they opt for mid-tier iMac with two additional USB 3 ports. But that's it. If you ask me, I use USB-A devices all the time. I hate to drag dongles with me everywhere like it's my underwear. That's why, to me at least, Mac Mini is better value. It provides more. Blackbeard hosting. Simple, easy to use website installer, 24/7 customer support, real people, and more. Hosted on fast, reliable, and secure servers. Check it out. 1 month free trial, no credit card needed. With Digital Marketing's code, you get 5% off. Blackbeard Hosting. Hosting as it should be. This may sound a little bit weird, but let's talk about the display. We know Mac Mini doesn't have one. In contrast, this year's iMac is coming with gorgeous 24-inch 4.5K Retina display, but then you can easily find great monitor for your Mac Mini. And these are still good 4K screens. Frankly, they may be away from iMac's display in terms of quality and color, but 4K for $250, that's really tempting. Since we are talking about multimedia experience, I can't help but to mention, below the iMac's display lies capable speaker system with support for latest Apple technologies. iMac seems more complete as a machine. Same thing goes with accessories. By looking at the box of the Mac Mini, it's almost stripped naked. The fact is, you don't have basic tools to use it. iMac, on the other hand, with its beautiful display and even a webcam, arrives with great magic keyboard and magic mouse, which sucks, but you can still use it. Realistically, we can still find some amazing Logitech accessories for less money, but if we are honest, iMac once again has the advantage. But right when it strikes you how it makes more sense to go with the iMac, things may turn. For anyone that's on the budget, the following two factors may be deciding. I'll share my personal experience. When my MacBook display broke, whole computer ended up completely useless. Yes, I could connect to external display, but that's not it, right? That's not the point, especially if we look at the amount of money that's being paid for MacBook. No such issues with Mac Mini can happen. I mean, if there are problems with display, just connect it to some other monitor and boom, you still have fully functional computer. You can't beat that. Yeah, there could be some other problems, but as well as any other. Finally, the price. And I think we're all clear that we can manually configure Mac Mini, make it fully operational for less money that we would need for mid-tier or even very basic 24-inch iMac. It may not be such a beauty, but mini desktop Mac is a beast on its own, especially since the inclusion of the M1 processor. Besides being affordable, it is also a serious contender and powerhouse, so that's why it is my choice. Now, it's up to you. What is yours? Please answer below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you subscribe, hit the thumbs up, and leave a comment. And you may be the lucky winner of world's first snap tablet stand made by MOFT. Thank you so much for watching Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.